animal behaviors. Every creature that lives on the earth behaves in distinct ways. Behaviors are the ways animals and humans interact with each other or with their environment. A bird builds nests where it will live and raise its baby birds. Dogs sit or roll over because they may get a treat or a pat on their heads for doing those tricks. People blink to moisten or protect their eyes, and spiders build webs to catch their prey and for protection. Some behavior is learned, and some behavior is innate. Innate means you were born with a certain behavior. These behaviors are automatic. They happen without you thinking about it. Learned behaviors are behaviors that must be taught to animals and humans. Here are a few examples of learned behavior. A dog is taught to sit up, shake, roll over, and where it will go to the bathroom. You were taught how to walk, write, and eat with utensils. A baby is taught how to crawl and then how to walk. All these are examples of learned behavior because someone had to teach the dog, you, or the baby how to do those things. Here are a few examples of innate behavior. A dog knows how to dig a hole. A spider knows how to build a web. And you know how to blink and grasp something. The dog, spider, and you were all born already knowing how to do those things. No one had to teach you. A human is the most intelligent animal on earth. Humans have the least number of innate behaviors. Most human behaviors are learned behaviors. In fact, the only innate behaviors in humans are reflex behaviors. A reflex behavior is a simple action that happens without you thinking about it, like blinking. Reflex behaviors occur in response to stimulus. The word stimulus means an event or something that happens to you that creates a specific reaction in your body. Here's an example. If your friend is hiding behind a wall and you walk into the room where she's hiding and she suddenly screams out, "Boo!" you might cry out or jump. That's a reflex or a response your body made when your friend scared you. Your friend scaring you was the stimulus and your body involuntarily jumping is the reflex. You don't think about reacting that way. Your body simply responds to suddenly getting scared. The same thing happens if you touch a hot stove. Your hand automatically pulls back. Another example of a reflex is when you go in for a physical exam at your doctor's office. When a doctor taps your knee with the rubber hammer, your lower leg automatically kicks. The hammer hitting your knee is the stimulus, and the reflex behavior is your leg kicking. Reflex behavior is an innate behavior because you did not need to learn a reflex. You were just born with it. Animals have many more innate behaviors than humans do. They occur naturally in all animals, just like they do in humans. For example, all dogs know how to dig holes. A dog does not have to practice digging the hole. It can dig a hole for the first time it tries. And it will continue to dig holes in the same way for its entire life. Innate behaviors are sometimes called instincts. These innate behaviors are predictable, which means we can guess or predict what will happen. Let's look at some innate behaviors in animals. Here is a cat stalking or hunting a mouse. This group of baby birds is gaping their mouths open for food. Here, a turtle hatchling is digging its way out of sand just after it's born. And this little baby is sucking on a bottle while grasping its blanket with its hand. All these animals and the baby were born knowing how to do each of those things. There are many other examples of innate behaviors in animals. Remember that animals do not have to practice innate behavior to get better at it. Animals never change innate behavior unless they have to adapt to a changing environment to ensure their survival. A behavior can be a combination of both a learned and an innate behavior. A dog knows how to dig a hole, but it may have to be taught where it is okay to dig holes. Learned behavior is the opposite of innate behavior. A learned behavior is either taught to an animal or it is developed from an animal interaction with its environment. Sometimes we might confuse innate behaviors that animals and people are born with behaviors that are learned. For example, People are not born with the ability to speak, but it might seem like they are because once a child begins speaking, it seems to come easily. However, if a child was born in the wilderness without other people around, that baby would only grunt and make sounds it hears in the wilderness. That's why speaking is a learned behavior. Someone has to teach young children how to do it. One type of learned behavior is called habituation. The word habituation just means a behavior that becomes a habit. In fact, the word habit is in the word habituation. That can help you remember what the word means. An example of habituation is how you learn to brush your teeth. When you started to learn how to brush your teeth, you may have been raised by a parent when you did it. Or maybe you realized that brushing your teeth is the best way to avoid bad breath and cavities. Eventually, brushing your teeth became a habit. Now, you no longer need the praise to perform the learned behavior of brushing your teeth. Another type of learned behavior is called imprinting. Imprinting is used by ducks, geese, and a few other animals. It happens when baby ducks or geese focus all their attention on the first object that they see, hear, or interact with after they're hatched. When ducklings hatch, they will imprint on the first adult animal they see, which is usually the mother. The ducklings then begin to follow the mother around and imitate her. Sometimes imprinting is thought of as innate behavior, but it is not. Because if ducklings or newborn geese first see a human instead of their mothers, they will imprint on that human and follow it around instead of their mothers. If imprinting was an innate behavior, the ducklings would ignore the human and try to find their mother. There are also learned behaviors called conditioned behaviors. There are two types of conditioned behavior, classical conditioning and operant conditioning. Classical conditioning is when we hear or see something over and over that causes us to have certain reaction. For example, every day at noon, the school lunch bell rings. After a few weeks of school, you might notice that when the bell rings, your stomach growls and you suddenly feel hungry. That's because your body's become conditioned to the sound of the bell, meaning it's lunchtime, and you get hungry as a result. Operant conditioning is a learned behavior that is often used in training animals. For example, a person rewards a dog with a treat if it performs a certain behavior, like rolling over. But if that dog goes to the bathroom in the house, the dog might get punished. Eventually, the dog learns that when it does a trick like rolling over, it is an accepted behavior and will earn a treat. But going to the bathroom in the house is not an accepted behavior, and the dog will get in trouble. In summary, some behavior is learned and some behavior we're born with, but every animal and human behaves in distinct ways.
Thanks for following Clarendon Learning. Be sure to subscribe. For more free resources, check us out at clarendonlearning.org.